will not attend the Capitol tomorrow for the inauguration of President-elect Donald Trump. One Democrat who will be there is Congressman Elijah Cummings of Maryland. He joins us now. Congressman, always a pleasure.
Good seeing you.
So you're going. Does that mean that they are wrong to not go?
No, I think that they should do what they believe in their hearts. Chris, you got to understand that we members of Congress have a lot of information that the public does not have. And I can tell you, over the last week or two, the classified briefings that I have been to, and if the public knew what members of Congress know,
why don't they? Aren't you there for the people? Aren't you supposed to be relaying
Now, Chris, you just heard me say it's a classified briefing. Now, you know,
But if it's that important, it's going to make people not go to the inauguration. I take your point about confidentiality.
Yeah.
But if it's that important, people know.
You're making the very point that I've been trying to make, and that is that we need to be doing more. Number one, investigate the attacking and also we need to be doing more with regard to looking at the FBI director and what he did in this whole situation. And by the way, the House has done hardly anything. I don't think we've done anything, really. And of course, the Senate, under Senator Byrd and Intelligence and Senator Warner, they are doing some things. And what I'm worried about, Chris, is that it seems as if the Republicans are sort of letting President-elect Trump just move forward with regard to, say, the conflict of interest issues, then this whole hacking issue. And I'm really concerned that we as Democrats have to push more harder on Republicans to do something so that their standards are met and that he gets rid of these conflicts, and that he also deals with
all right,
the hacking.
But let's bundle it all up into the one main premise, which is either you respect the process.
That's right.
Or you don't.
That's right.
And if you don't show up for the transition of power, the argument is made is you're not respecting the process. Now, John Lewis has done this before with President Bush 43.
Right.
He said, I didn't like what happened with the Supreme Court case. I don't think
that's
it's legitimate.
Right.
He's saying it again now.
Yeah.
And he's got basically a group with him. You know, I know some people have some different reasons about why they're not going.
But Chris, they got proof to show what
they're talking about, or they're just disrespecting the process.
Chris, let me tell you, information will come out later at some point where I think the public will fully understand. My situation is I want to be a witness to history. My forefathers have worked hard to give me and others these opportunities. And so I want to be there to be a witness, but I also want to be understood that this is our watch. And we've got to protect this democracy. This, to me, is bigger than President-elect Trump. I'm concerned that we are moving slowly but surely towards a crisis of legitimacy with regard to our core institutions, CIA, FBI, NSA. I can go straight on down the line. Even our Office of Government Ethics has been attacked by the Republicans. And so I think some of us will be outside and doing very constructive things and meeting with constituents, while others of us will be inside. The other thing, Chris, that I want to be clear on, at some point, a lot of information is going to come to me as the top person on the Oversight and Government Reform Committee, and I don't want anybody to say, well, he was one of the people that was just protesting. I want them to understand this is not about Democrat or Republican. When that information comes to me, I want to be able to say I acted almost as a judge.
I hear you
to put
that.
It forward.
This is loaded stuff, though.
Oh, I know it's loaded
suggestions
stuff.
Suggestions are loaded. You got Hillary Clinton's going to be there tomorrow with her husband.
All right.
So obviously she's respecting the process, and all this legitimacy stuff would somehow influence what happened with her, I'm assuming, through the Democratic narrative. But there's such loaded suggestions. This information is going to be coming. If the American people knew it, we knew.
Yeah.
Isn't there a responsibility to do something with that kind of suggestion? Because it's like a poison pill to dump it into the process.
Chris, you know this. I do not control the information. Republicans are in control, and you know that. And so they control the whole flow of things. So hopefully we will, at some point, you know, we've got the investigation going on in the Senate. Hopefully the House will begin to do some investigations itself. But the key is to do what I and Congressman Swalwell of California have suggested. We need a 9/11 type panel where independent people, not congressmen or senators, independent panel, distinguished people, come in, look at the evidence with regard to hacking and any other things they need to look at, and present all of that to the American people with recommendations.
I get what you mean by the 9/11 panel, but that was about understanding how something happened that we knew happened, okay? Mm-hmm. This is different in as much as there is a suggestion, correct me if I'm wrong, that what could be developed is so powerful that it could rationalize delegitimizing the outcome of the election.
Well, you're saying delegitimizing. I didn't say that.
I'm saying it is the smell
you're saying
of it.
That.
It's the implication I'm getting.
Well,
from
I'm just telling
back
you.
Back me we've off got, it if that's
we've got, No, we've got 17 intelligence agencies
right.
who have already said
right.
the Russians hacked. That's right.
They were behind the
And now we need to find out more information about that. We also need to find out how they did it, and we need to have recommendations as to how
but
to do it.
But do you think that it's even possible that you would get to a place where what you learn legitimately calls the outcome of the election into question?
I leave that to the future.
But right? I'm saying even...
Chris, all right. I leave that to the future. In other words, you present evidence, just like a judge, a jury. You present the evidence. The evidence has got to come forward and let the public take a look at it. I don't know what that's going to come to. Tomorrow, though, I will be there acting as a witness to history.
Me too.
Yeah. And you got your ticket?
No. I'm in the media. That's my ticket. Congressman, thank you for being with us, as always.